Okay, so now we have the wireframes implemented for both screens. But what does it look like on the tablet? Well, unfortunately, when we take the phone UI and stretch it out on a tablet, it doesn't look that great. There's a lot of empty white space here. We could better take advantage of this screen real estate by showing more useful information. For example, why do the details need to be a tap away when they could just as easily fit on this screen? And furthermore, if the user wants to look through the full list of forecasts, their eyes must go like this, which is an unpleasant reading experience. If we want the user to read some content, we should keep the width narrower so that they can scan it quickly. These considerations are part of responsive design. Responsive design means designing your app by keeping in mind that it will be used across a range of different device screen sizes. But how do we do that? And what does it mean to build for larger screen devices like tablets? Well, I can show you some examples of how apps adapt using multi-pane layouts. In the Android Design Guide, there's a section on multi-pane layouts. One technique is to combine multiple views together. For example, in the People app, you have the contact list and the contact card for additional details. On the tablet, we can put them side by side. This is also known as the master detail flow. This is the master list, and this is the detail pane. In the Settings app, we have another example. The column width adjusts based on the available screen width. In the Calendar app, we have panels, and they stack vertically in the portrait orientation, but horizontally in the landscape orientation. There are also a couple other examples that you can look through as well. If you want more information on designing for tablets or responsive design in general, you can check out the links below for more details. In this course, we're learning how to build up the phone UI first and then the tablet UI. But in reality, when we were designing it, we thought about responsive design from day one. When you're building your own app, it's bad practice to just completely design and build your phone app and then start to brainstorm about the tablet UI. That's because the tablet UI often has an impact on the phone design as well as the architectural decisions made here.